Good evening. Welcome to the Buck Stops here. I'm Vishnu Shom. Well, today for a change, there is a new development on the pollution front, which could just be the start of something positive. The government has actually said that should odd even start again, then they would include two-wheelers. And that's going to be a big change. Whether it can be implemented or not, nobody knows as yet. But it is a signal of intent, perhaps a recognition of just how bad the situation is. This recognition should perhaps have come a long time back, not this year. It should have perhaps come a couple of years back when it was already starting to look terrible. But if the Delhi government does in fact go about taking a step as drastic as this, getting two-wheelers off the roads as well, then perhaps we are headed in the right direction, because a couple of other steps have already been taken in the last couple of weeks. The ban on diesel generators, there is talk about extending the ban on power plants belching dirty smoke in the in and around the Delhi area as well over an extended period of time. So these are small steps, but the bottom line is this: those are all steps. The reality is that we are in a desperate situation. Even though today in the National Capital Region we actually weren't in the very severe category of air, we were still in poor air conditions. In fact, five times the World Health Organization limits. So we're going to be discussing this, looking at the way forward, and really being honest, is there going to be a solution over the next couple of months, or are we going to be back over here in what, October next year, November next year, discussing the same thing? Before I introduce my panel, we've got a small studio audience with us as well. And joining me in the studio, Dr. Anupam Sibal, Group Medical Director. He's a senior pediatric gastroenterologist at Apollo Hospitals. Thanks very much for being with us. Jyoti Pandey Lavakre is a concerned mother and joins us in that capacity as a mother. She is also with the Parents Teachers Association of her school, a children's study in. Bharti Chaturvedi is the director of Chintan and an environmentalist. Ajay Jadeja, a familiar face over here, certainly somebody who would have a lot to say on what we're seeing with cricket on the field. Ashish Khaitan of the Aam Aadmi Party with us as well, and we'll also be joined by Sheila Dixit, the former chief minister. But first, a quick look at the changes which might now start taking place.
Women and two-wheelers will not be exempted from Delhi's odd even ban on vehicles, the Kejriwal government has told the Environment Court. Last month, the government had refused to implement the ban despite severe pollution because it wanted women and two-wheelers exempted. But now, pollution is likely to worsen, according to the top body mandated by the Supreme Court to cut pollution. This could happen the next time there's severe plus levels of pollution in the capital. To reduce the sea of red across the NCR, the Environment Pollution Authority, or EPCA, has once again pleaded with states to strictly take action against pollution sources. But like this fire at a Delhi garbage site shows, it takes weeks to see action, not least because of many government agencies and municipalities involved passing the buck.
So whatever comes directly under Delhi government have been done. Whatever comes under municipalities, the municipal corporation commissioners have been directed, and I hope things are getting implemented.
While experts do not expect pollution to be much lower this year either, some steps like the ban on diesel generators, shutting down the Badarpur coal power plant, as well as brick kilns, may be paying off.
What it's showing is that in November last year, 2016, at least 54% of the days had severe pollution levels.
Okay.
This year, in November, it's 41%.
But that is clearly still not enough, as is evident from this particular advisory that NDTV access exclusively. It is from the Environment Pollution Authority to the states of Haryana, Delhi, Rajasthan and UP, asking them to show zero tolerance in trying to stop all those sources of pollution that are making the current levels of severe. In New Delhi, Amitoth Singh for NDTV.
Well, let's go straight across to Ashish Khaitan of the Aam Aadmi Party first. Ashish, what made this government change its mind? Why will you now include two-wheelers as part of the ban once odd even starts?
In principle, we still believe that it is important in Delhi to exempt women and also two-wheelers. But because there is a graded response action plan which has been approved by the Supreme Court, and we have to act as per that graded action plan. So we will work as per that plan. And if the weather conditions breach the severe plus category, then odd even as per the NGT order will come into full effect without any exemptions. But that's not the only point. There are 13 other equally important points, which is enforcement of a strict ban on the use of pet coke, use of gensets, and complete ban on civil construction activities, and enhancement of public transport, especially increase in the frequency of metro. So there are it's a whole gamut of action that the government is going to take. But Vishnu, I still like to point out that this will only go and do so much. The reasons and the factors of air pollution in Delhi lie beyond the realm of the territory of Delhi.
Okay, we'll talk about that
later, Ashish. We still need concerted and coordinated action.
I take that point. We'll talk about that in a little while from now. But I just have one more question to you. If you've agreed to do all of this now, what stopped you from taking these steps a few weeks earlier on?
As I said, all this is being done as per the graded response action plan.
There was a graded pollution action response earlier on as well. Odd even had to be introduced when it got particularly bad. But now you're saying that you're going to include two-wheelers. Why was this not included earlier on? I know what your principal problems are. I appreciate those problems. The city needs to somehow function. Women need to feel safe. But we are dying in this city. Why did you not realize that a few weeks back?
Let me put this in context, Vishnu. Let me remind the viewers and you in particular that AAP government was the only government and the first government till date to enforce odd even. We were slammed. We got a lot of flack at that point when 2 years ago we decided to enforce odd even. So this government has never shied away from taking bold, courageous moves to tackle air pollution. Now, nothing has changed over the last 1 week. What has changed that we feel that under the existing severe climatic conditions, we have no other option because governance is always weighing between different options.
Okay, so better late than never.
You have to strike a balance.
Better late than never. Perhaps that option, that balance we could have looked at earlier on as well. Bharti, now that this has been introduced or will likely be introduced and the air pollution levels will go up, unfortunately, one can just hope that it doesn't, but the chances are it will. How much of a difference is it going to make in our lives in the NCR?
Well, I really believe that this is absolutely not enough. I appreciate that it's being done, there's no doubt, but it's not enough. I mean, unless India looks at air pollution with the same passion and commitment as we look at the Aadhaar card, you know, everywhere you go, link your Aadhaar, do this, do that. I mean, unless you treat it as something that important, I mean, if we drop the Aadhaar card scheme today, people would not die. But air pollution is killing us. It's literally costing our lives. So I think until we look at it as a national priority that is, obsessed the top policy makers and politicians of our country, these things still only remain, band-aid
solutions.
But
let's welcome a small step.
I welcome it completely.
We've been critical of every government and will continue to be that.
But we're critical, but we're welcome.
13 steps have been taken. Doctor, assuming that this actually brings down the number of vehicles on the road, it's bound to. There has to be a drop in air pollution levels. Is this likely to make our lives a little bit better?
Definitely, it's a positive development, and anything that will bring the pollution levels lower, that will improve the AQI, is welcome. But I think one thing that all of us need to realize is that, I see news headlines and it says it's 500 and it's 700 and then suddenly it's down to 300 and everybody says, oh, it's so much better. I mean, when will we realize that actually our aim is that AQI is less than 60?
Right? Yeah.
Okay,
and
it's been stretched.
60 is the upper limit of acceptable.
Okay, so it's been stretched to 100 for our environment. So we are three times, four times, five times, and we are sort of getting the sense of relief. And what we need to realize is, and we saw examples of that, and I'm sure Ajay is going to comment on what it does to you when you're actually involved in strenuous activities. And my heart goes out to all our traffic cops, to all the people who are, using cycle rickshaws. What are we doing to their health? I mean, we talk about, children, we're talking about elderly, we're talking about those with asthma, we're talking about those who have respiratory condition, that's fine. But what does prolonged exposure do to otherwise healthy people?
And so it's really going to damage. So I just want to quote from a UNICEF report which has come out yesterday, in fact. Air pollution can potentially impact children's developing brains. It's not just a potential link to cancer, a potential link to lung development, a potential link to asthma. We know all of that. It can potentially impact children's developing brains. The vast majority of babies at risk, 12 million, are in South Asia. The part of this area which is the worst polluted is the part we happen to live in. Ajay, you spent your childhood playing cricket. You couldn't be caught inside your house. But it's sad now, isn't it? That your kids, my kids, everybody's children over here, when they go out to play, and as parents we want our kids to go out and play, we put them in harm's way. I don't know. I mean, how do you feel about that as a sports person?
Look, I think, you know, I don't know the details of it, but living in this city over the years, you can clearly see it. I mean, you don't need any data to tell you that, you know, it's not breathable air out there. But when you live in a city, how long are you going to do that? And it's not just 5, 10 days, 15 days in a year, which is bad, which can happen anywhere in the world and you can get over it. But if something's been on for years and years and it's only getting, you know, the pollution's getting worse and worse every year, the only choice that people are left with is either live with this or, you know, you leave the city and go, and which is not a practical, you know, solution for it. And I accept what Dr. Saab said. I think it's what we start accepting. And today we're talking about air. 20 years ago, I hope we had talked about water. We wouldn't have had to have water purifiers in each house. So, you know, when you don't start asking for something from anybody and you start solving it within your own little circle, or for my house I put a water purifier and forgot about what's happening with the water, I hope that doesn't happen to air, because each of us are now just putting air purifiers in our house and not worrying about what's happening outside. So I just hope that doesn't happen. Apart from that, you know, I don't have a solution. I'm just a citizen of this city, and it is sad to see the air quality that we breathe day in and day out.
Ajay, cricket, we had a Sri Lankan fast bowler throwing up. We had an Indian fast bowler, Mohammad Shami, throwing up. After he actually said that, look, you know, I mean, maybe it's not necessarily that bad. Should we have cricket in the winter months at the test level, at the Ranji level in Delhi?
Look, I think that's about 20, 30, 40 odd people. I'm glad what happened. Although I accept that, I mean, from a cricketing point of view, it was a tactical move by the Sri Lankans, but I'm grateful to the Sri Lankan team, being a parent and a citizen of Delhi, that at least when they put that mask and there was a whole issue during that game, that at least people have taken notice of it. So I am grateful to the Sri Lankan team. But, you know, it is something that was a tactical move within the game. So I don't think, because if was the case, the game was over 5 days. Today was probably the, you know, as he said, the nicest day of all the 5 days. It was most clearer. So if they were concerned about it, they would have probably stopped or said, we don't want to play the game at the start of the game. But it is, air quality is bad. There is no, I don't think there's anybody in this city or anybody who's visited this city over the last many years. Yeah. And it's not just a couple of years. I think last 10, 15 years,
who
every winter, it is only getting worse. So I don't think we need anybody from outside to come and tell us that, you know, the things are bad.
Jyoti, let me ask you this. As a parent, you know, we've all seen our children not being able to go to school. We could well enter another situation when our children can't go to school again. And we don't know how long that's going to be. How is this impacting the education of children quite besides their health? And it's something that's going to keep going on as there is greater awareness of the health risks.
Firstly, I don't think we should accept that this is something that should continue to go on. This is a national public health emergency, and it is important for the leader of our country to recognize it and talk about it and take concrete action. I think it's very important to have an accountable and empowered body to take charge of this situation, make it a mission of national importance and solve it. How can we say that tomorrow schools will shut down for 5 days or 10 days and education will not happen? We're not a third world country. We have to move forward. Today's UNICEF report says that our children are going to have, you know, are at risk of brain damage. They could actually have
neurological behavior problems,
cognitive
brain damage.
Exactly.
It can affect IQ, memory, reduce test scores among schools. It's It's atrocious. It's unbelievable.
So, and you, I mean, the question is not about how children will go to school. The question is how can they even study with cognitive impairment like this? Yeah. Also, you know, the Central Pollution Control Body itself had commissioned a study which said that Delhi children have almost 44% of Delhi children have lung damage,
yeah,
irreversible lung, yeah, damage. The Journal of Indian Pediatrics has said that children, again, I think they have talked about Delhi children, and they have said that Delhi children have lower lung function compared to, Indian children have lower lung function compared to anybody else in the world. These are not things we should be taking, you know, as a, okay, this is acceptable, now let's move on. Even in odd even, you know, when you talk of odd even, it is actually, no one is looking at the fact that we are still subsidizing dirty fuel like diesel. So if odd even happens and I have to get to work and I get into an Uber, which is not a CNG Uber, because there are Ubers which have taxis which
have run on diesel,
yes,
as well.
So how am I even helping the
that
air
cause
by taking? So
okay, I just want to go across. Does anybody have a comment over here or a question to anybody over here? RG, please go ahead.
Sir, the
who are you asking?
I am asking this,
yeah,
person.
Yeah.
We are talking about this weather in the normally in these months, which is generally bad. Now they play cricket without consulting the India Meteorological Department whether it is conducive to play the match. If you go for a marriage, you consult a pandit before you say what is the right thing. But when a cricket match is being played, why don't they go to the India Meteorological Department and find out whether playing a game in
Doctor,
the country?
I just wanted to ask you about the impact people suffer when they go out and play sport. What is the medical impact?
So I think the first thing to understand is that we normally say go, you know, exercise and it's great for your health and be fit because we have a huge problem with obesity. But we have to balance this. At this point in time, you know, when your AQI is more than 300, 400, we say don't even go for a walk. So, I mean, where lies the question of a jog or running or marathons or badminton matches or basketball or cricket or football? It is just purely something that you can't do because,
okay,
the air is just so bad. You are causing yourself damage, and that damage is not just today. It's going to be medium term, long term.